Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? I hope you are doing good. Students, today we are going to continue with unit 16, which is more about fractions. And today's topic is fractions of a number. Let's do a short recap, students. On this slide, we have two fractions. Which is the fraction in red? Come on, think and tell me. Yes, it's 1/2. And which is the fraction in black? Yes, it's 1/4. Now students, on this slide also we have something that we had done earlier. Now if you look at the first circle here, it says finding half, and you can see that half of the circle is shaded. The second one, the square, it's finding quarter, and we can see that one part is shaded out of the four. The third one, finding 1/3, we have a triangle and one part is shaded out of the three. The next, finding 3/4. So we have three parts shaded out of the four. And the last circle, finding 2/3. So we have two parts shaded out of the three. This we had studied in the previous lesson of fractions. Now students, let's start with today's lesson. Wow, yummy! What do you find here on the slide? Yes, you can see that there are cakes. Come on students, count and tell me how many cakes are there on the plate? Yes, there are 8 cakes. Now what we have to do? No, don't go and eat the cakes. Here we have to find half of 8. Now, to find half of a number of objects, you need to divide them by 2. Yes, when we find half, we have to divide it by 2. So first we are going to count the number of cakes and then we are going to divide it by 2. I'm going to give you time to think and tell me what is 8 divided by 2. Okay students, I hope you have got the answer of 8 divided by 2. Now on this slide we can see that there are 8 cakes, and divide the cakes between the two children so that they have the same number each. Now the best way to do this is one for me and one for you. Okay, because division means to share equally. That's right. So what is 8 divided by 2? Yes, your answer is correct. 8 divided by 2 is 4. Now students, on this slide you can see that after dividing 8 cakes equally, how much does each child have? Yes, the girl has 4 cakes and the boy also has 4 cakes. So the half of 8 is 4. Now let's go to the other example. Now how many cakes do you see here on the plate? Come on, count children. I'm waiting for you. Yes, there are 12 cakes on this plate. And how many people do you see on the slide? Yes, there are 2 people. And we have to find the half of 12. Now I'll give you time. Come on, tell me what is going to be the half of 12? Alright students, I think you have already got the answer. So what is the half of 12? Yes, the half of 12 is 6. And you can see in this picture that each child has got 6 cakes. So the half of 12 is 6. Now students, here on this slide we are going to learn how to find a quarter. Now first, let's count and tell me, how many bones do you see on this slide? Yes, there are 8 bones. And who likes to eat bones? Yes, the dog likes to eat bones. Now, if you have to find a quarter, can you tell me by which number are you going to divide 8? Think. That's right. We are going to divide 8 by 4. Students, so I think you have already got the answer of 8 divided by 4. Let's check if your answer is correct. Now, here you can see that there are 4 dogs, okay, and there are 8 bones. Now, when we divide the bones between the 4 dogs, you can see that each dog has got how many bones? Yes, each dog has got 2 bones. So, what is the quarter of 8? And how many bones does each dog have? Yes, the quarter of 8 is 2. And you can see in the picture that each dog has got 2 bones. So, the quarter of 8 is 2. Students, on this slide, we are going to study how to find 1/3. Now, we already saw that to find the half, we need to divide by which number? Yes, we need to divide by 2. To find 1/4, we need to divide by which number? That's right, we need to divide by 4. So, what do you think now? We need to divide by which number to find 1/3? Come on, think and tell me. Yes, you're right. To find out 1/3, we need to divide by 3. Now, students, on this slide, you can see that there are 3 flowers. And how many butterflies are there? Count and tell me. Very good. There are 9 butterflies. Now we need to divide these 9 butterflies equally on the 3 flowers. So how many butterflies are there on each flower? Yes, there are 3 butterflies on each flower. Very good. So we have how many butterflies on each flower? Yes, each flower has got 3 butterflies. And what is 1/3 of 9? Right, 1/3 of 9 is equal to 3. All right, students, get ready. It's time for some challenge questions. Now, if you have found it easy to find 1/2, 1/4 and 1/3, now let's do some challenge questions. Now, students, here we are going to learn how to find 3/4. Now, we already saw how to find 1/4. Come on, tell me. When we have to find 1/4, we have to divide by which number? Yes, we have to divide by 4. Okay, now in this question, we have to find 3/4. Now, I want you to count and tell me how many eggs are there altogether? Yes, there are 8 eggs. Now, to find 3/4, first we are going to find 1/4. So, to find 1/4, we are going to divide it into how many groups? That's right, we are going to divide it into 4 groups. So, we have 4 baskets here. Now, how many eggs will be there in each basket when we divide 8 by 4? Yes, you're right. In each basket, there are going to be 2 eggs. Students, on the last slide, we saw that when we divided 8 eggs into 1/4, we have 2 eggs in each basket. Now, we have to find 3/4, and it's very easy. You just need to count the number of eggs in 3 baskets. So, count and tell me, how many eggs are there in 3 baskets? Exactly, you're right. There are 6 eggs in 3 baskets. So, what is 3/4 of 8? Yes, 3/4 of 8 will be 6, because there are 6 eggs in 3 baskets. Now, students, what can you see on this slide? What are the different things? Yes, we can see that there are three jars and there are how many paint brushes? Yes, there are six paint brushes. Now, we have to find 2/3. Now, you know how to find 1/3? When we have to find 1/3, we divide by which number? Yes, we divide by 3. So, you can see that there are three jars. So, there are six paint brushes, and if we divide these brushes between the three jars, how many brushes are there in each jar? Yes, as you can see that 6 divided by 3 is equal to 2. So we have 2 paint brushes in each jar. Now, students, on the last slide, we saw what is 1/3 of 6. Now, we have to find 2/3. So, as we said that it is very easy to find 2/3, we just need to count how many paint brushes are there in 2 jars. So, in the 2 jars, how many paint brushes can you see? Yes, there are 4 brushes in the 2 jars. So, 2/3 of 6 is equal to 4. Thank you, dear parents, for all your help, support, and cooperation. Take care of yourself. Students, stay safe, stay indoors, take care of your health. We'll see you soon, inshallah. Goodbye.